Hi, my name's Carly. I'm Pet Program Manager at Berkeley Humane, and this is Alphabet, and this is Rosie. Today, I'd like to talk to you about one of the most important aspects of cat safety, and that's collars and ID tags. Unfortunately, almost 10 million pets are lost in the U.S. every year, and collars can be the quickest, most reliable way to get your pet back when they're lost. Now, collars aren't a replacement for microchips, and it's really important that every one of your pets have up-to-date microchip information, as well as a collar with an ID tag. Now, this goes for indoor cats as well, because if they get loose, you want anyone who comes across them to know that they're not supposed to be outside so they can contact you. Also, indoor cats tend to get scared and might flee in neighborhoods they don't know, so it's really important for someone to be able to contact you if your cat is in distress and lost. There are many pieces of information that you can put on an ID tag or collar if you'd like to, but there are three things that are really important. First is your cat's name, the second is your phone number, and the third is whether your cat is indoor only or indoor/outdoor. If your cat does go outside, also put your address or a general location of where you live so someone who comes across them will know if they're doing their daily routine or if they've strayed too far. When you're choosing a collar, the most important thing is to make sure that it's a collar made for cats and that it has a breakaway mechanism so that it can't get caught on anything and cause a choking hazard. Now, this can be in the form of a stretchy material that comes over the head, of Velcro, or a clasp that comes open easily. When I'm testing a collar, the first thing I do is put it around my arm and see if I can pull it apart with my pinky. If it won't come apart with that much pressure, then I won't trust it to come off of a cat if they ever get stuck. Now, some cats are not quite as amenable to wearing collars as others. If you're adopting a kitten, start them wearing a collar early so that they get used to it. And if you have an older cat who does not particularly like wearing collars, you can acclimate them to wearing one. So get a collar and fit it nice and loose so it can slip over their head and have some tasty treats ready. What you'll do is slip it over their head, give them a couple treats or a little bit of tuna, something special, and then take it off right around when they're done eating. Do this a few times a day at random times, and then you can start leaving the collar on for a little longer and longer and start spacing out how quickly you're giving them the treats. If you have a cat who will wear a collar but is really good at getting them off, I like to just have a big supply of cheap collars, and every time I notice that the cat isn't wearing one, just put another one on them so that I'll know most of the time they have an ID tag on them. So I sincerely hope that you'll never end up needing an ID tag on your pet. But if they ever do go on an ill-advised adventure, you'll be really glad to know that someone will know how to find you.